Hey guys, it's Chris Serino again from the Sultana Education Foundation. Today I'm going to be showing you one of the most incredible documents ever produced of the Chesapeake Bay, John Smith's map, published in 1612. So here's the man himself, Captain John Smith. If you're not familiar with the story, he's one of the first Jamestown settlers. They arrived on the shores of the Chesapeake in early 1607 and set up shop right here in Jamestown. And over the course of the next 2 years, John Smith made some incredible voyages of exploration on the bay to produce this map. So just looking at the map itself, one of the more interesting things to the modern eye is that it looks to us like the map is on its side, because north is actually to the right. And a lot of early maps of the bay were drawn in this manner to match the perspective of ship captains sailing from Europe to what they called the New World. You'll see here in the water, Chesapeake Bay. Where did that name come from? Well, right here at the mouth of the bay, the first tribe that you would have encountered were the Chesapeake Indians right here. And that's where the name is derived. So this is a remarkable document. This is really the first decent, moderately accurate map of the bay. And Smith shows you where he went. There's actually a key right up here where he says, "Signification of these marks to the crosses have been discovered, and what beyond is by relation." So coming back to the map, let's take the Potomac River, for example. Smith is telling you he traveled the length of this river and went as far as this cross, and everything beyond that is by relation from talking to the native peoples that he encountered. So Smith went up almost every major river on the bay and put this together, and it's really a remarkable document. Let's look at some of the cool features here. So up here in this upper left-hand corner, you see the Council of Chief Powhatan. Now, Chief Powhatan had kind of set up a confederation of about 30 different tribal groups here in what is today the state of Virginia. And this is what apparently it looked like when Captain Smith was delivered to the chief as a prisoner, and he was about to be executed when Pocahontas, one of the chief's daughters, threw herself over him. So that's a really iconic image here. You can see the name of the map is Virginia, and you might be asking yourself, well, if this is the Chesapeake Bay, where's Maryland? Well, this was published in 1612, and the colony of Maryland wasn't established until about 20 years later, in the early 1630s. So at the time, Virginia stretched from the Carolinas all the way up to what is today New England. Moving across, this is the Stuart family crest, the royal family at the time in England when Smith was making these voyages. This is one of my favorite things on the map. This is a Susquehannock Indian that apparently Smith met, and he described this warrior as the goodliest man we ever beheld. He had apparently his thighs were 3 feet around. And Smith wrote that the Susquehannocks are a giant-like people and thus attired. So you can see this gentleman's holding a long bow that's as tall as he is. He has a bear skin garment draped over his shoulders. That's the nose of the bear. These would have been the eyes right here. He's holding a large wooden club. He also has his hair shaved on one side, and that's a typical hairstyle for the Algonquin Indians of the area. They would shave usually the right side of their head and let the other side grow long to avoid the snap of their bowstrings. Now, if you can zoom in down here, this is John Smith's coat of arms. This is a really unique little symbol here. The most notable thing are these three heads of Turkish warriors that apparently John Smith beheaded in hand-to-hand combat in Eastern Europe prior to him coming to Virginia. And this is Latin down here, which is translated to conquer is to live. Moving along, we have a scale of leagues. A league is a unit of measurement that was used back in the day. You can see the date 1606. That's the date that the English settlers set sail for the New World here in Virginia. So the last feature on this map, and probably the most important to me, are these red dots. These are color-coded by Sultana. We added this coloration to kind of make the map a little less busy and easier to see. These are Native American communities that John Smith mapped during his travels around the bay. He mapped over 230 locations of these native towns, and it's really quite remarkable. You can see these larger longhouses represent what he called king's houses, really these were paramount chiefs that were presiding over these waterways, which really served as kind of the ancient highways of the pre-European Chesapeake world. And you can see the dense populations as these villages were basically, these communities were set up in clusters along these rivers, and they tended to cluster in areas where the resources were prevalent, whether it was oysters in the lower rivers or these wetlands up here where spawning fish runs were happening. This map not only changed the way that Europeans saw the bay, it also opened up the floodgates for settlement that later had incredible ramifications for the cultural and ecological layout of the Chesapeake Bay. An incredible document.